It's time for lunch. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. Today's video, I have got four super easy and delicious summertime lunch ideas. Today's video is extra special because it is a collaboration with my girl Sammy over at Managing the Maze. Y'all already know she's one of my YouTube besties. So if you have never heard of her before, definitely check my description box. I will have her channel and her video linked down below. Sammy is a working mama. She works outside the home as well as doing YouTube. So she's gonna share lunches that she packs and takes to her with lunch. And then, as you know, I am a work from home mama and I have a little kiddo. So y'all are gonna see my lunches that I fix for us at home. So I really hope you guys enjoy. I hope this gives you some lunch inspiration from both of our channels. But let's go ahead and get to cooking.
We're gonna start out with some snack wraps. Y'all have no idea how much I wish McDonald's would bring back their snack wraps. That was one of my favorite things that I got from McDonald's, and they are gone. So we're gonna make them at home today. It is really easy to put them together. No, they don't taste exactly the same, but it is a really good at-home version. So I just got a bag of frozen chicken strips. This is just the Kroger brand. This was my first time trying the Kroger brand. And honestly, they were really good, and I will definitely be purchasing them again. So I'm going to put all of those on the tray and get them put in the oven according to the package directions. Luke did come home for lunch this day, so you will be seeing my plate and Luke's plate. I forgot to share Winston's plate, but he had it deconstructed. To go along with it, I just cooked up some tater tots. We already had those in the freezer. Here were Luke's two. He wanted one of each. He wanted one ranch and one honey mustard. So I just put the chicken tenders down and then put the ranch and honey mustard down, added on some shredded cheese. And then he likes regular lettuce, so I put on some shredded lettuce, and then I just rolled them up and put the tater tots on there. I think I gave him some ketchup, but I forgot to film that for his tater tots, and that was his plate. And then for mine, I personally like honey mustard, so I did some of that on there, and then the shredded cheese, and then I like spinach. For some reason, I don't like the texture of lettuce, but I like the texture of spinach. I don't understand it. I'm weird. I already know that. Y'all don't have to tell me that, but I just added that on, or rolled it up, and then I got me some tater tots and some honey mustard for dipping. I did forget to get Winston's plate, but he just had some chicken tenders, some tater tots, and some honey mustard. He's not a fan of stuff like all wrapped up together, so that's what he had. Next up, we are keeping it simple, and I'm having a bologna sandwich with cheese and Duke's mayonnaise on some homemade bread. I will have my homemade bread recipe video linked down below for you guys in case you missed it. To go along with it, I just had some chips and some watermelon. And then for Winston, he had a kind of snack aboard. He had some watermelon, some banana, some cheese cubes, some bologna, and some bugles. Lunch was done. Next up, we're gonna do chicken parmesan sliders. Y'all, these were so good. All you need is some either pizza sauce or spaghetti sauce, some chicken nuggets. I did the Hawaiian sweet rolls. I used some of the Chef Chamois butter for the topping and some cheese. I cooked up the chicken nuggets according to package directions. I did only end up doing 9 sliders since it was just Winston and I. Once the chicken nuggets were done, I took and cut open the sliders, put the chicken nugget on, added some of the pizza sauce, topped it with some cheese, closed it up and put the sliders in the same baking dish that I cooked the chicken nuggets. That just helped me with dishes. And then I'm going to top all of those once I get them all in the pan. I'm going to top them with that garlic butter, and I topped them with a little extra cheese, and I baked these at 350 for about 10 minutes. And I'm telling y'all, these were so good. It was something different, and Winston killed them. Here's what they look like when they are all done. Y'all, these were so good. You definitely need to give these a try. I think these would even be good for like a potluck or a church picnic or anything. We just served them up with some fresh fruit and lunch was done. We had to run a few errands this day, so Winston and I stopped at Sonic. We both got corn dogs and tater tots. He got an orange Fanta, and I got a large ice water with blue coconut, peach, and mango syrup. I found that version on TikTok, and I have been ordering it ever since. It is so good.
For lunch today, I am pulling out what we have in the fridge, and I'm gonna make some turkey bacon ranch pinwheels. And I'm super excited, to be honest. I've not made pinwheels in so long. So we always have flour tortillas. That's something that we keep on hand. So I've just pulled those out. And then we got ranch. Always keep ranch, Italian, all the dry mixes. Got that. And then I had cream cheese in the fridge. Also have the turkey in the fridge. I'm just gonna cut it up into small pieces. I've got some bacon that we have left over. I'm gonna cut it up and add it in. And then I have a little bit of sharp cheddar and some pizza blend. So I'm just gonna mix the two of those together. And I'm going to mix all of this together in a bowl, smear it on this, roll it up, and let it sit in the fridge until lunchtime. So let's put this together.
I'm gonna first cut up my bacon and my turkey. And then in a bowl, we're just gonna go ahead and add in our softened cream cheese and only add in a half of your packet of ranch. I accidentally added the whole thing. We still ate it, but it was super salty and ranchy. So if you make this, only do half of a packet of ranch for one block of cream cheese. And then you're gonna add in your shredded cheese and then add in your lunch meat and your bacon. And then you're just gonna mix all that together and we will put it on our tortillas. Now that it's all mixed, we're just going to add it to our tortillas. I just like to do a thin layer. If you like lettuce or spinach or anything, you could definitely add some on there on top after you get it all smeared on and then roll it up tight. I do like to put these in the fridge for a couple hours. So I normally make these either the night before or the morning of, and then I just put them in the fridge for a few hours. These are perfect for poolside snack, easy lunches, easy meal prep that you could, you know, make, say, Sunday and then have them to eat on all week long. These are such a good option, and you can make these with so many different proteins, you know, make them different ways, and they are delicious. So I've just put them in the bag, and I'm going to put them in the fridge for a couple hours. Then we'll get them out and slice them. I'm just going to slice them up in my container, and then that way we can eat on them for the rest of the week. And here they are after they're all cut up. I personally like to eat the ends myself, and I just keep the perfect circles for everybody else. I just keep them in an airtight container in the fridge, and we just eat on them through the week. And that's it, guys. That wraps up today's video. I really hope you enjoyed these four super easy and delicious summer lunch ideas. I hope this gave you some inspiration to cook more for your family at home. Don't forget that today's video is in collaboration with my girl Sammy over at Managing the Maze. I will have all her information listed in the description box below. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.